I just bought the best domain I've ever bought in my life. The funniest new domain is .pizza.
Oh, .pizza.
And I spent half the last recording of the name attack, like, on domain.com buying fuckyou.pizza, which is now officially in my grasp. I own fuckyou.pizza. Brian, I dreamt of a world where I got abusive to a slice of pizza, and now my dreams can come true on fuckyou.pizza.
Hey, what'd you end up doing with fuckyou.pizza, Justin Robert Young?
Let it lapse!
Hello, you beautiful citizens of the internet. Demon hordes, gather around, for it is Tuesday night, and tonight we set the world on fire because it's Night Attack, bringing you the best of the worst of the internet. I'm in Austin, Texas. I'm Ryan Rushwood, joined by my BFF and OK, it's JRY. What is up, Justin Robert Young?
Business, Bri.
Oh,
business is what's up.
You got biz eyes?
Tonight, it goes down. Mikey Neumann is back on the show. He's bringing another quiz. And after the shameful display that I put on last time, I feel like I got something to prove.
Yeah, dude. He's claiming on Twitter that you're already pre-melting down. He says he's seen it before. Dr. Neumann has a diagnosis, and the only cure is not more funk, but more punishing failure. That's the only way.
I don't care what the hell he sees, man. That guy, he's going crazy these days, doing all of his – he's probably nervous, getting ready for his live Movies with Mikey panel at PAX South coming up in 2 weeks. He's projecting all of his jitters out from wherever he's at in the suburbs of Dallas into this show, and I will not have it. I'm going to demonstrate my worth in his quiz this evening. But before we do that, we do have something that we need to recognize.
Yes.
Happy birthday, Brian.
I'm not going to say.
Happy birthday, Brian.
Do you remember the apparently all I want to do is talk about old sketches, but they did that one with Jack Black. They proposed a new birthday song. It was pretty epic. Anyway, thank you. Yes,
was
me.
This one on Mad TV too?
No. That was on Saturday Night Live. Because okay. it was a fairly tepid episode for how much I love Jack Black.
Burn. Retro burn.
Retro burn, person who I still deeply admire. me, Betty White, First Lady of the United States, Ben Franklin,
Amtrekker,
Jammer B.
Brett the Amtrekker Roundsville is born today as well. Jammer B, I think, our old friend on NSFW show at the Twit Network.
Yeah. So last night, I got sick, right?
You did. You caught a little bit of the old bug going around.
I guess, yeah. But you feel like, okay, your body knows, right? Your body freaking knows, and you can argue with it, but it knows when you're a liar. And if I have a show, it does not matter if I am death walking on stilts. My body knows it's like 500 people, Brian, 500 people. You're going to get out there. You're going to do your show. Everything else can wait. And you did, and I've done those shows where miraculously, I remember having Bonnie. I laid there on stage and just pointed to where stuff went and then just got up and did the show and then laid back down to being dead. we gathered everybody for the weekend to shoot a whole bunch of Modern Rogue episodes. And we planned to do 8. We got 1. Mm-hmm. And a quarter. Mm-hmm. And then at the end, we just sort of had a business meeting and I was like, well, I'm trying to do that thing where I'm trying to lie to my body. I'm trying to be all like, oh no, man, this is like do or die. You got the whole team together. There's only a few. You're gonna run out of episodes and die, be alone on the street. And then meanwhile, my body's just like, you sure about that?
And seems this was like the end of a long day. This was like a 10-hour day.
Yeah,
we were coming up on 10 hours.
Yeah, day. But I'm trying to rally, and my body was not having it. Yeah. And then, like everybody. It was as though the whole room except me had the same idea at the same time, and they're all like, "Hey, you know, if we pushed, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world."
Yeah.
And why don't we do this? Just 8 a.m. tomorrow. Let us know how you're feeling. And then they walk out the door. I go to bed, And then I post in the Slack at 3 a.m. like, hey, guys, you know, I was feeling like 80% chance we were all good, but now I'm going to have to lower that to 50. And then nobody hears anything from me until 5 o'clock the next afternoon. It was
– yeah.
And that vomited everything that I touched. Like, somehow stuff that wasn't even inside me comes out.
All I know is this, is I talked to you, and I can't remember if it was Sunday morning or Monday morning. I wound up talking to you, and you were like, hey, I just vomited up a bunch of soup, and I'm like, oh, man, that sucks. And so we're talking and everything. And then all of a sudden you get into this little, like, laughing fight with Bonnie. And I'm like, wait, what's going on? And you're like, I'm hungry. And so I just asked Bonnie for more soup, and she won't give it to me because I already, like, I 5 minutes ago vomited up all the soup that she gave me, and she doesn't want to run out of soup. Does not trust my stomach to hold the soup for as long as it needs to be in there for nourishment, and so she won't give me soup anymore.
It was the literal argument you have with a toddler. It's like, no, you don't get more. You just threw that on the ground. No.
But now it's your birthday.
Yeah,
you had a good birthday so far,
dude. It's been great. I was talking to, you know, you know that I could get a little neurotic and in my head, and I was talking to Bonnie last night. I rewatched The Big Lebowski and realized how much I've spent my life being the Big Lebowski, and how much the last year has mellowed into the dude. maybe a little too much, maybe to the detriment. Maybe I needed some of the Big Lebowski again, but regardless, man, fat and happy, dude. Fattest and happiest I've ever been. 42 is gonna be a hell of a year. 2017 is gonna be great,
dude. You did have a fun little moment today with your birthday cake.
Right. So before I went to bed, I texted Justin, and we've talked about this dumb game on the show, right?
Yeah, we have. Oh, no, it's exploded. Not only has it exploded in the chat, it's exploded on Twitter. It is now our game of sending this, like, months-old Harambe meme to each other and trying to force the other person to look at it has exploded like wildfire.
What's the best way
all of Diamond Club?
What the best way to see it is what?
Oh my god! What?
So the picture is it says, this is the photo of Harambe the Cincinnati Zoo doesn't want you to see, and it's Harambe rocking out with a flying V guitar, diving into a pool with chicks and bikinis behind him. And it's just
so
the best.
That's a Photoshop of me trying to explain the Rosario Dawson-led Bernie Sanders protest that was running through the press tent of the Democratic National Convention. So I'm pointing like a weatherman at now the picture of the meme, because the meme is just everywhere. The meme has infected literally anything that we would possibly touch.
Well, and so it escalated, and I don't know if we talked about the escalation when I went through Bonnie the other day, right?
Oh,
so
my gosh.
Bonnie's like, hey, where's that image? Where's that Harambe picture you keep sending Justin? And I was
here it is. That's how we got on the topic, and okay. it went out. So everybody heard that story.
Got it. So it's on fire. And so last night I was just get ready to go. I was sick, you know, I was in one of those lonely moments where I woke up in the middle of the night completely felt alone in the house because everyone was asleep, and I had slept through the whole day because I was sick. And I'm going through, like, maybe I'll do some emails, and I'm going through nextdoor.com, and I'm telling you, man, there's so much gold in everybody's Nextdoor. Like, if you're not doing Nextdoor, just find out how psychotic and racist your neighbors actually are.
Nextdoor, as I texted you, Nextdoor is only the suffix for, did you know a racist lives?
Right.
It's so, okay, it's how I go, hey, if you got a kid in a turquoise shirt ringing doorbells and running away, I'm literally calling the cops on him. And then someone said, and then, you know, follow up, you're like, oh, man, if back when I was growing up, that's the kind of thing that get you killed. And he's like, hey, please don't threaten children. And then, next thread over is, I found a dog. I lost a dog. No, that's the wrong dog and all this. And it just everybody's angry. And so I just type the words. I've never
posted. Can you bring it up? Can we see it?
Yeah, I think we can.
No.
Okay.
I have no idea where to look for this.
Is that show where you guys live?
Yeah, I'm worried about the.
All right. Well, here I think I still have it in my text.
I just write the words. Gorilla costume, and I post. I've never posted on this thing, but acting as if it's super important, I write, "Hey guys, just so you know, I might be running around the neighborhood in a gorilla costume at some point. So if you see what looks like a gorilla with, like, I don't know, a guitar, just don't freak out. Also, here's a picture of what it will look like." And so I realized, like, number one.
And by the way, Ryan's not putting on any vocal affectations. This is literally, it's written. So if you see what looks like a gorilla with, like, I don't know, a guitar,
yes,
just don't freak out. Oh, also, here's the photo we're looking to reproduce. So again, if you see this happening, don't freak out. Right.
It's
by the way, no replies. Apparently that, if you lose, I drop my Pez dispenser. 50 replies. Your son's a Nazi. Yada, yada, yada.
We got three replies.
We actually did. Because I sent that to you, like, the moment it happened.
And I am
uncontrollably trying to contain my laughter because I am doing two things that I love. I am trying to shake up that dumb pattern that neighbors fall into. It's just like I just, that's me standing up on a chair and saying, no, all of you, no, knock it off. More stupid stuff starting now. But the realization that I'm also harambeing them and that I could send it to you and harambe you as well had me very, very, very thrilled. But we got like four comments. Three of which were eye rolls, and they were like, classic Brian. That's our Brian.
I said, that's why we love the brushwood.
Because you remember.
She's for real. She really likes us.
You remember when we shot. Do you remember when we shot the crazy psychotic hobo Brian
stuff? Oh, I know. I walked into my living room, and I lost my crap. I was like, oh, what the hell?
I am still hearing from neighbors about how, because we did a long shot where I was just raving like an insane person, and it was a pretty great costume and beard I was wearing, but nobody could see a camera. It was just literally a psychotic screaming man running up and down the greenbelt back behind my house, and this is why these warnings are important.
So that's why. All right. So with that backdrop, that's how you started. And the way you explain it to me is you're also hoping that Bonnie has to look at it the next morning.
Right.
Right.
So what Brian doesn't know.
So I wake up and I wake up, after like 3 hours of sleep, because, you know, when you're sick, things get a little silly. I wake up, but I realize, like, oh, Bonnie's about to go get the kids and get them all out the door. So I'm like, I got to go downstairs and get in trouble. And then I was like, because in my mind, I'm going to be all like, there's a weird article on Next Door you should read or something. But I walked down and I was like, hey, Bonnie, have you looked at Next Door? And she goes, yep, loved it.
I think
Bonnie's down with it. It's all a great time. It's your birthday. You sleep in a little bit. Everything is going well. Life's a peach. We are about to get ready for this show. Because you were sick. We had to move weird things to today.
Yep.
Doing weird things. We're doing after things. It becomes clear that you have a heart out because you have to go and sing happy birthday with your family because this is about the time that the girls start going to sleep.
Well, and it's in a serious text. Like Bonnie's multiple texts, and the girls are clearly up to something all day. You know, they're writing cards and Penny comically is covering and suddenly gives me the lizard like side eye of like, don't you look at what I'm up to. And it's clear, like, you know, don't make the kids stay up late. Let them sing happy birthday. And so I think I can just sneak out of the end of weird things.
Yeah.
And then turn around and come back.
So here, before we reveal what happens, just understand that the end of the After Things episode is Brian running back into the studio screaming expletives.
Did I curse? I didn't know I was cursing.
Yeah,
I think you did.
You cursed.
I think,
in front
I
of the
think
children.
The line, you ever effer, you've crossed the line, you ever effer.
This is, well, out of hand.
Because I am convinced at this, there's a brief flash that I think you're all in on it together, and it's all again, you're all against me, and that's why you guys were so generous to let me run on downstairs.
So let's go ahead and take a look. Do we have the picture?
We do have the picture. That is my.
That is his cake, ladies and gentlemen. His cake. Brian, please describe what you see.
It's a cake that Bonnie and the kids made. That is an astonishingly amazing likeness of Harambe rocking out on a flying V guitar while jumping in spring break in 1997. It was. This is the cake that the Cincinnati Zoo doesn't want you to see. Look at that side by side. Oh.
And the kids totally helped out. I didn't want to let them do it because I was like, don't mess it up, but I did.
That's how serious it is. You're like, don't fuck it up. Don't fuck it up.
Don't mess it up, but they did. They totally, like, Josie did the guitar and Penny did the others. What is she, painted it?
Oh, this was a Brushwood Girls production. You didn't get it at the HEB or nothing?
No.
No.
Can you make a guitar-wielding gorilla on my
I mean, yeah, you can bring, I don't know, you bring a picture anywhere. No, they'll squirt it out on a cake, right?
Yeah,
but that's great.
Penny,
that's even better. That was a homemade cake. Oh, jeez. I can't think of anything better. Happy birthday
kind.
Brian. There is one present that you can give Brian, and that is your money. Go to patreon.com/nightattack.
If you'd like to make him just a little bit fatter and a little bit happier, then why don't you head on over to patreon.com/nightattack, where I got to tell you, man, Patreon support has really, really bolstered everything. We've told the story here several times, but going independent was a terrifying thing for us, and you guys absolutely changed our lives for the better. If you want to play a little video game, you could go to graftreon.com/creator/nightattack and see how we're doing in the standings. But basically, we seem to be holding steady. And most importantly, once you make that jump from being a nothing contributor to a something contributor, you get your very own RSS feed that you put in your podcast app. Yep. And instead of just one measly hour and change of our horse shit, you get a 3-hour rock block. And it's pretty funny.
And early access to the pre-show and post-show.
That's right.
A couple of days before it goes to public.
Yeah, so you're a superior person.
And, of course, if you change your pledge or become a new person who is donating to the patreon.com/nightattack Patreon, then you, sir... You or madam get to participate in this segment, a segment that Brian does that I'm stalling for. It is...
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Night Attack new Patreon name chant corner hour.
It's an hour of... Dude, are you ready? I'm excited about this one.
Mm-hmm.
Because we got a new pledge.
Oh.
A new person.
And it's somebody we know. It's somebody who showed up on last week's episode. Now, we had a lot of guests.
A lot of call-in guests.
On last week's episode.
A lot of guests.
Yeah. But I'm talking specific. It's not Ernest Borgnine.
No, okay.
Oh, my God.
It's Vern. I don't know what you're up to, but thank you,
Jason Bryant.
Hi, the D-Man.
Thank you, Jason.
Thanks, Jason Bryan.
Everybody go to Jason Bryan on Twitter and tell him he's the best man on Earth. Actually, psych, don't tell him that. because the best man on earth is about to show up right here on this show. Of course, you know him from all of his fabulous work at Gearbox, as well as his amazing YouTube series, Movies with Mikey. You'll be able to see him live at PAX South when he does his Movies with Mikey panel. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Mikey Newman's back on the show.
Huzzah! That's not Mikey Newman. That's me. Not... We just got Harambe'd. How you doing, Mikey?
I'm very good. Can everybody see me?
Yeah. We can see you, and we our love will find a way.
Hello.
Dude, you've been lighting us up on Twitter. You seem fired up about this one.
Well, I mean, it's all in good fun. I actually do genuinely like you, and I'm afraid I have to hurt you in this way.
Right? This is the equivalent of making sure that it's all safe space and we're all friends here.
Yeah. This one is just particularly hard. Like you're gonna wonder what level we're playing at, and I'm gonna look back at you and say I forgot.
Like, all right.
There is a layering here.
For those of you guys who do not know, these Mikey quizzes are, do we have a name? I guess just Quizzes with Mikey, right?
Yeah, Quizzes with Mikey's fine.
Yeah. Quiz. This is such a big deal that there are actual Vegas odds makers who put a spread up on the big board.
Less competitive this week.
It's weird. Normally all the action.
Well, the reckoning from last time.
Normally I'm the long shot, but
I don't know how you read it. I don't know how to read this.
Explain. All right, so basically, I am a half question favorite, meaning that only really serves as a tiebreaker. So if Brian and I tie, he wins. And then the money line is even, meaning if you just wanted to bet on either me or Brian, you wouldn't. Brian, it's even for me. You have to lay a little money.
Yeah.
To
so like if you did a dollar bet on Brian and I win, you would get $2 back. But if you if you did it on Justin, you'd get like $1.80 back or something.
Yes.
But the total combined correct is that's where we get to act as a team. Like, how are we as a team going to do? This is the question. Where if
I
we
also
get,
don't know why the under was scrubbed out.
Maybe because
I think it
number?
Gives you info.
We tweeted
it like midway
based
through
on
the
how
day.
Many there are.
Oh, yeah. Interesting.
All right.
So the over under on the total number is 21.5. If they beat, if they collectively beat 22,
all I care about
wins.
Is being the over on both. I don't care if I personally beat Justin, although this year, I have to this match.
Thank you, Mitsula. We love you.
And let's also address the elephant in the room, which was I have been very successful at the Mikey quizzes until last time. I'm gonna just go ahead and apologize. I want to apologize to everybody who was watching. It was unprofessional of me to start stripping down and screaming incoherently.
Stripping down and screaming incoherently is literally part of this quiz.
Oh, jeez.
That's how far in your head I am.
Oh, jeez. He knew it. He's like Sherlock.
I'm not kidding.
He made the appointment 3 weeks ago. It's all set up.
I also want to just understand that I do feel that the quizmaster seems to be leaning particularly hard on one of the contestants and not the other.
Okay,
one.
Well, keep in
it's
mind the other contestant
on one of the contestants.
The other contestant has a reputation for losing any kind of. The other contestant invented the game Secrets or BS and has never won it. Has the worst BS filter of all time.
Yeah. All right.
Hold on. I'm gonna tweet out that the quiz is starting right now. Starts now.
So what is the quiz this time, Mikey?
So I wanted, I wanted to celebrate a year together, sort of, for all of us, because I've been doing the show about a year now, I think. So this is, did that actually happen in 2016? ?
God damn it!
Wow.
and the key. And the key here is specificity. Were you paying attention? Because you're going to notice some oddly densely packed statements. And you have to tell me.
So there's a chance, if I'm reading the tea leaves here, there's a chance that that something could sound mostly right, but we didn't pay enough attention to it, and so we're actually super wrong.
Within reason.
Yeah, okay.
Right. You it's never like
it never like
happened at 11 p.m. and it was actually 11:05. It's never that.
I swear to God, one of the questions better not be did a boat sink.
If you get any of these wrong when I reveal to you why you're wrong, you will be like, oh crap.
Yeah. All right. Fair enough.
It's obvious enough, I think.
That's all legit. All right.
He says, smiling.
Who won? I guess I won the game last time, so I guess I have honors, as they put it in golf, which means I have the worst position of going first. Right.
I went ahead and wrote the names down again this week. We got Brian.
Yep.
And Jalerp, I believe is what I wrote. Hang on.
Jalerp. That's the sound Jalerp. I made when I vomited up all that soup.
Yeah, just a jeweler. All right, so who's going first?
I think that's who Jyn Erso is sitting next to at the beginning of Rogue One when she's on the prison transport.
Hello, my name is Jlerp Erso. It does not roll off the tongue.
It's not the sexy one that sticks tendrils all in your orifices and reads your mind.
Huh?
All right, so Brian won last time, so Brian needs to go first?
Yep.
Brian goes first.
Ready.
All right, number one. Star Wars The Force Awakens opened in China. Did that actually occur in 2016?
Yeah. So the question is, was there worldwide simultaneous release? And I am not looking at the chat. You could probably a good idea behind the chat. Well, I don't know. Chat's wrong about a lot of stuff. I'm going to say yes. Yes, it did in China. It did not have simultaneous worldwide release.
It did not happen in 2016. It happened in 2015.
So here's what's odd.
I interpreted the question.
You did, Brian. You interpreted it wrong.
Yeah.
With the wrong reasoning and got it right.
Yeah, that's hilarious.
So, which I think affected.
I'm telling you, dude. I'm an idiot savant. I'm baby's day out. I just walked forward and everything
works. Was irrelevant. The reason you were correct is that it did not have a simultaneous release.
Wait, didn't? So the answer was no.
It came out. No, it did.
The answer is yes, because it came out. Not in the calendar year that it came out in America.
Yeah, the quote was, Star Wars The Force Awakens opened in China. That happened in 2016. Star Wars The Force Awakens opened in America happened in 2015.
Yes, because I am dumb.
God, if we're confused on the wording of this question, we are in some trouble.
So,
guys.
Yeah, I'm good.
No. I got that one. I just didn't get the answer correct. Right. I feel that's – all right.
All right. Questions moral going to Jalerp first on this one?
The chat's already saying, commence Jerry Meltdown in three.
No, two.
He's on. Don't put undue pressure.
That was Jummy. Those were Jummy days, baby. This is Jalerp now.
Everybody calm down. I'll feed you baby birds. It's a slow burn. Okay, let the master work. All right. Number two. Taylor Swift broke up with Chris Pine. Did that happen in 2016?
That did not happen in 2016.
Yep, I'm going to say it did not happen as well.
Both correct.
You did not date Chris Pine.
Yeah, I don't think not at all. All right, going to Brian.
By the way, it's tough because I admit I'm dumb and I admit that I never know what I'm doing, but I also have a 9-year-old who is obsessed with pop stars.
Yeah,
I'd like to think it was not a completely uninformed.
So wait a minute. So who did Taylor Swift break up with in 2016?
I don't know. I would have been
Tom Hiddleston was one of them.
Was Harry Styles?
That's a fake relationship. Calvin Harris.
Fake news me?
Yeah.
I got enough of that last week, homeboy.
Uh-oh.
All right.
Uh-oh. Oh man. If you're not watching video, the game faces I'm seeing.
All right. Number three, Brian Brushwood.
Yes. Ready.
A dinosaur skull was stolen from a natural history museum and the police found it with Nicolas Cage.
I'm sorry, say those words again.
I will read the question again if jury agrees to the second reading. Jury concedes. Thank you. We have a decorum. a decorum.
But you said
tired.
We have a decorum, which is also true. We're very classy.
We're very well dressed. I had an 8-hour migraine today. It was a long day.
We're good. All right.
I'm reading it again. A dinosaur skull was stolen from a natural history museum, and the police found it with Nicolas Cage.
All right. I am going to say that did happen in 2016, but it's not the Nicolas Cage that we're thinking of. It's a clever little wacky news story that happened to happen in 2016.
You're saying it's true.
I'm saying yes, that is a thing that happened in 2016. And I'm calling my shot so that you guys don't think I'm baby's day outing it.
Yeah. All right.
I believe it is true. And I believe it was he had it in his possession. It was like it went. All right. Yes, true.
Correct. Brian, for the second time in a row, you have gotten it correct and called your shot wrong.
God, love it. I'm that asshole at the bar. Just slop. Just played 8-ball wrong. It don't matter.
You are 3-for-3. It is 3-2. Very close. So he bought a dinosaur skull from a vendor, and the vendor had previously stolen it from the museum. So when it all came around, he just gave it back.
Classy guy.
That's nice of him.
Yeah.
I mean, for a guy who stole the Constitution, that was a very classy thing for him to do.
For the right reasons, though. For the right reasons.
I mean, all right.
Hey, listen, all the only way to stop a bad guy with a Constitution is a good guy with a Constitution.
That is correct. I've heard that.
High endurance role.
Number 4, Mr. Jury.
In the chat.
Jalorp, please.
Jalorp.
Jalorp. Ryan Lochte pled guilty to obscenity charges for revealing himself at a Brazilian Wendy's.
That is not true. That did not happen in 2016.
I mean, this is the Olympics.
You said Wendy's, right?
Yeah,
I did. He did. Brazilian Wendy's.
Yeah. No.
That's a good question. That's a good tack, because of course, if the story was, I mean, Ryan had some trouble in 2016. We know that. The question is, how popular?
Really?
How popular is Wendy's in Brazil? I'm gonna project my mind. I need a franchise. Yeah, I'm living in Rio. It's not going to be a Wendy's. I'm going to say no. I'm going to say it's not true.
So you both said not true?
Correct.
You were both correct. It is not true.
I swear to God, if it was a Wendy's, I'm going to be.
I just got a really good idea for a horror movie where I like lock you guys in a basement and then I do like the quizzes to you and you have to figure out what level of bullshit I'm operating on.
The other one gets punished, electrocuted when we screw it all up.
Look who's back. I am pool boy. Guys, I'm really concerned for Jerry. I don't think he can handle another loss like this. He's too fragile.
It's fine. We're fine. It's 4-3. Brian is currently 4-4. This question.
Another way to phrase that is, has a perfect record so far.
Okay, well, let's.
I mean,
let's
say, if you want to use more syllables
for like the early teens, maybe
undefeated also works.
That's like saying I hit the first 4 pins down in bowling. Let's slow down here.
Fair enough.
Number 5, Brian.
Yes, sir.
At a wrestling event at the 2016 Olympics in Rio, the Mongolian coach protested a call made in a match by taking off all of his clothes on live television.
Okay, first of all, in the entire history of Night Attack, I have never seen Justin's eyes involuntarily bulge as wide as they did as when the phrase wrestling match was just spoken during this quiz. You said that, and his eyeballs, they spun and hit jackpots, and out came money. I'm going to say it's true. It's so dumb it's got to be true. And that's probably the wrong reason. That sounds insane. Did he do a thunder flap? That's the important question.
So this happened. The question is whether or not. No.
I will not allow another reading of the question, by the way. Because you're right. I think his move was in the semantics.
Oh, I know it's in the semantics. The question is whether or not why he took his clothes off and whether or not it is Mongolian. Those are the two vectors. And I think that it did not happen as he said it.
So you have disagreed?
I've disagreed.
Brian gets a point.
Off of the I-beam onto the skyscraper. Just keep walking forward. Everything will be just fine.
Next one's very good. I'm going to read it and toss it to jury, and then you're going to hold your answers because I've been holding my pee and I got to go pee.
All right.
So, but it's might take you that long anyway, so it's fine. Jury, number six.
Yeah.
Ken Bone, the man in the red sweater from the final presidential debate, signed a development deal with Lionsgate.
All right.
That did.
Let's have a conversation. Wait, you're locking in first, Justin?
He said it was to me, right?
Yeah.
No, he said Lions. Or was it Lionsgate?
Well, what? So you're acting like you've heard that he signed a development deal.
Yeah.
Do you know who Ken Bone is, Brian?
Yeah, of course I do. Ken Bone is one of my fellow participants in the Reddit Secret Santa this past year, and you would have known that had you gotten the mass mail that they sent out saying it was me, my boy, Ken Bone, I'm Snoop Dogg, and old Billy Dog is who we call Bill Gates.
Emails Brian Brushwood.
It's either Lionsgate or it's Warner's.
I'm really curious where the conversation is right now.
I'm gonna stick with no. I'm gonna stick with no.
You're saying no, Brian?
I did not hear about this at all, so I'd have to do the asshole tactical move and also say no.
Both correct.
Nailed it.
It was the second debate.
Was it the third debate? See, the second
debate. St. Louis, the third debate was in Las Vegas.
He didn't sign a development deal with anybody. I just thought it sounded so absurd.
He didn't sign a development deal with anybody, and also it was the second debate.
Justin, were you just playing the game?
I was.
Oh. Playing the game.
I know Brian's not going to go against me on any of these now that he's ahead.
Yeah, well, Brian's betting.
Oh, so you're calling your shots, but you're like whispering them. You're writing them in a sealed envelope, and then like a mentalist at the end of his act, revealing, "Oh, I knew that would be the case because even though I hate the show Sherlock, I'm going to be him after every question now."
All I'm saying is that I know that you're not going to go against me on any of these things, I need to do my best to muddy the waters.
If we can take a second for the intermission, we're about to move into the Florida portion.
Oh, unfair.
16 quiz.
Also, this is
the next four questions take place entirely in Florida.
Justin,
I have never been more happy with being behind 2 points.
Now, Justin never doesn't live in Florida anymore.
Oh, dude, Florida left with him when he went. I mean, are you kidding me? He's made of pure Florida. Oh. I mean, this dude.
All right.
I don't want to whisper the devil's name lest he come to our house. But like, literally, if anything will put a substantial dent in our long-term friendship, it'll be this game because this shit. All right. We're pretty good at play fighting, and in the past, it's turned into not play fighting.
Sure, and but this is a game.
I know, but it's so much fun.
Of all the play fighting, this is the most completely
but I
controlled
feel like Okay.
Who called Brian Meltdown? Who called Brian Meltdown?
No, but here's what I'm saying.
You're up two.
You're winning by so much.
That's why it's so surprising.
Well, no. Here's what's happening. First of all, last time was the closest like I ever had to worry in years about like, oh wait, is it not fun? Is stuff about to get weird? And it did not get weird, but. Fucking you say Florida, and I see that wild-eyed fire in this motherfucker's eyes, and he's already laying out these false tales like, no, yeah, there was definitely a Ken Bone deal. I just can't remember. Was it Lionsgate or was it Warner? Fucking with me. Like, fucking, I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. So I'll be real careful.
These worries are going to look really foolish if there's a Texas section next.
Yeah, baby.
Are you saying you're going to throw the game just for Justin's feelings?
No, he's saying that he doesn't like playing the game strategically.
You know what? Let me write that in an envelope labeled prediction. And then that way I'll have it. So in case I lose, I could say, oh, you may want to see this then.
By the way,
I threw the game or whatever.
Brian almost destroyed our marriage right after it started by like beating my high score in Centipede. So we know he won't do that.
Yeah. Bonnie's never played Centipede again.
No, he crushed me.
Okay, ready.
Let's get to the Florida of it all.
Does everyone remember we were playing a game?
Yep.
Now
and
that
it's
we've
all
taken
about
our sabbatical.
How Justin was made of Florida.
Number 7, the first of the Florida section goes to Brian. A Florida man woke up from a 48-day coma, and the first thing he asked for was Taco Bell.
That's to Brian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so here's the thing. That is, without a doubt, the single most believable statement I have ever heard you speak. But you put it in the Florida section, which is all their wacky news, because that is literally probably what I would say coming up after 48 days. I'm going to say true because it's boring.
Interesting.
Because it's a very un-Florida story to tell. It seems like the most natural thing someone would do. That would be like a man cut his lawn, but it was in Florida. Do you believe it?
This is definitely something that happened. The question is whether or not it is in Florida. Or whether or not he is screwing with the days and it was actually like a 30-day coma or a year coma.
You know what it was? It was Wendy's. That dude foreshadowed it by mentioning
Wendy's. It was about Wendy's, Taco Bell. No, I remember the Taco Bell thing. What did you say, Brian?
Doesn't matter.
Ooh. You said it's true.
Yeah.
I am going to say
there's a third game for the live watchers is the poker face of the game.
we should get something set up where they can vote as a group and they also guess and we can track them like collectively versus
but we can't see it. That'll be
true, because that'd be like
I'm gonna try to no.
Okay, so here's the thing. I thought the thing that would throw you off was that it was a 48-day coma, which is an astronomically long coma to wake up from.
Yeah, no, and in fact, I thought the same thing because traditionally, like the Hollywood version of coma is you know you're out, you wake up like, oh, I'm an old man, what, a cell phone? Yeah. But realistically, it's like you're drowsy, sleepy, and you just never really ever come out. Yeah,
but it is true.
And it happened in Florida.
Yeah, and this is, but like when you're like, this is too boring for Mikey, and I'm like, this is the most unprecedented moment in American history, and the guy asked for Taco Bell. This is the most absurd. So you were again right for the wrong reason.
Well, I disagree because there's a lifetime of guys waking up from coma stories, right? And they all have the
on
first
television.
Thing they said. All right, fair enough.
All right, Jerry's coming to you.
Let's go.
It is currently 7-4. You need to make some tracks here. All right.
Well, I mean, I'm not, because Brian's just going to pick everything I pick. So.
Only if you're right.
Part of it.
I mean,
we might as well just skip this one.
I mean,
go ahead,
Mikey.
Number 8. A Florida man had his name legally changed to Bruce Jenner to retain the name's heterosexual roots.
It does sound mighty Florida. But I will say no.
This is the problem, Justin. Is you pre-ascribing meaning? Because I made, you know what I'm going to start doing? And oh, maybe this is what you're trying to goad me into. Because the moment I heard this, I said no. I thought no. And I'm like, no, it's definitely no. I'm going to start writing down my shit. How about that? Because I'm not just voting the same thing as you. I'm only voting the same thing as you just because you happen to be right on this one. As you have been on 50% of them so far.
Okay. You're both wrong.
God damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it.
Oh, no.
Baby just walked off the skyscraper and fell down.
That's fine. That's fine. At least I put a dent in Brian's perfect record.
It did.
I'll say to you, it's less important to win that than that Brian doesn't win with a perfect win.
Hey, listen, if it bleeds, we can kill it.
All right.
We are on number 9. Going back to Brian. A Florida woman quit her job so she could breastfeed her 36-year-old boyfriend full time.
I mean, it really doesn't matter whatever
I
say.
Can we say that again? Can we say that again? Brian, will you consent to say that again?
Yes.
A Florida woman. Okay.
No, go ahead. What's the question? Hey, Mikey, here we go. Next question. Mikey says it in 3, 2, 1, and go.
A Florida woman quit her job so she could breastfeed her 36-year-old boyfriend full-time.
I mean, it doesn't matter what I say. Justin's just going to say the same thing.
Oh, my God. Is this what this game is? Come on, Brian. Come on.
You're up by 3. You should cruise, Brian. You should cruise here.
Here's the thing. Yeah, you know this is like a thing, a community. It's like... it is a specific fetish that, like, I don't know, use massage and hormones to induce lactation.
I don't need this explanation ever.
But like, people who are committed to this fetish are committed to the level where quitting your job to play mommy is probably dream retirement to them in this situation. My only question is whether or not it's a Florida
thing. Do you belong
thing.
To that subreddit, or is it just a passing interest?
Fucking, I've got legendary R&D. You don't even want to know.
My RSS is blowing up right now. We're famous on that.
I'm going to say yes. I'm going to say yes. And if it's not true...
I'm going to say no.
I'm going
to
say, and if it's not true, it's just not in Florida. Or the age is wrong or something.
Or there's something else incorrect with it.
It's real.
The baby climbs out of the dumpster and keeps on walking.
Wait. Does he have like some kind of immunity disease? Is that why she's breastfeeding him? Or
No. Just Florida. Just Florida.
Oh my gosh.
Like there are adult women who like to take adult men
but there's so many
pretend
teeth.
They're a baby and
so little known teeth. Fact they do it all at Arby's. I didn't know that until I read this, but it's all at Arby's.
Yeah.
I mean, listen, have you had the Big Arby's. Montana? Great.
20% coupon if you use code NSFW at checkout.
This is our last Florida question going over to Jerry. Number 10. A Florida woman divorced a canoe, simultaneously informing the world that she had previously married a canoe.
Did it happen in 2016, ladies and gentlemen? Did it happen in 2016? I want to point out that everything that has been said in Florida so far, after being previously announced as a 4-question stretch, was true.
Can you please just say it again?
because I want it to become a song, just on the off chance it'll become a song.
I just do it like, a Florida woman divorced a canoe, simultaneous informing the world that she'd previously married a canoe.
No, Brave Jayhawk in the chat does point out it does sound like a John Oliver punchline. Previously, letting everybody know that she previously married a canoe.
Really does. Commence a bad Photoshop in his upper right corner.
Photoshop punchline.
Oh.
All right.
By the way, this is your first. I'm gonna go first. I'm out.
No, it's Justin's turn.
I know. I'm shouting. I'm calling my shot before he even goes.
Well, just write it down or something.
No,
then.
No. I this did not happen.
Wait, no, you can't say it first.
Okay. I unsay it. I'll just do this.
There's no reason to do this. This is.
Then I say yeah.
Psych, my answer is yeah.
You already said no. No.
I'm afraid we're going to have to go to the judges on that.
No, no, no.
Time out. We go with the. You picked up the piece. You got to put it down.
You straddle bet, dog. That's binding.
That's not cool.
No.
You got it.
I was trying to. I was being like that guy in the Golden Balls famous thing. They did a whole Radio Lab about it. Did you guys not see it? Anyway.
No.
I was.
Don't try to Radio Lab out of this.
It's on Money Planet. It's on Money Planet. I swear.
Yeah, Planet Money. No. I go with my first one. I said no, and I believe it's no.
I do submit to the judges that is beyond protocol.
Okay, hold on. It was only induced because somebody was mocking me for going with the same thing as you.
You
were engaging in Table Talk Psych Out. Which opens up.
Bryce, tell me what they both picked. It's your choice.
I say that he has to go with his original answer. No, Justin said yes, right? So that sounds like what we should do.
The answer is no, it is not real. It's fake.
Oh, and
I ain't
the
got
baby
point.
Keeps walking on a ladder.
Yeah, have you ever seen someone fall up a ladder? That's what we're watching right now.
Here's all I know. That's really offensive. That is an offensive move by you. That
what?
Is something you have now crossed the line.
What are you talking about?
Brian.
Okay. I was like,
all right, hold on. Time out. First of all, and you can decide what's in my heart, but in my heart, it was definitely a no the moment I heard it.
Just know you crossed the line. Crossed the line right there.
Hold on.
I feel like we were doing a good job walking through this. You got a little too hot. You crossed the line. It's fine. We can move on. I'm just saying you got a little too hot.
You know what it is? It's two punchlines. One is funny. Oh, Brian's doing a thing. But doing both, the like, gotta get in first.
Well,
and
okay,
gotta
yeah,
change my answer. That's your sin.
You're right. Because
how did Chuck
Woolery
do it?
You
how
guys
do you keep
don't
him
have,
on the game.
You guys don't have any way to tell when I'm joking and when I'm joke. No, but I'm really playing the game. Joking.
We're all joking.
I was definitely joking when I said ha, change my name. Like that was meant as a joke in my heart when I said it. I always meant to go with no.
Okay.
It's a
man.
All right. Number 11 goes back to Brian.
Oh, boy.
Are we out of the Florida segment?
We are out of the Florida segment.
All right.
It might make a surprise cameo in the 15th question, but whatever.
All right.
Number 11. Kanye West wrote a song about a talking tractor he dreamt about.
I'm going to say, yeah, I think he's talking about Mater from Cars.
That's a tow truck, not a tractor.
Yeah, he was thinking of one of the tractors that like got scared and falls over.
He's been right every other time he said a wrong
thing. You're right.
As well, like.
You're right. Logic is not a part of
it. I'm going to say yes.
Seance board.
So sorry, guys. I'm sorry I crossed the line. I didn't mean
no,
to.
No, it's over. All right.
You said no.
I said
yes.
You said yes.
I said yes.
Brian said
I believe
yes.
That happened in 2016.
You know,
you could say it again if you want to hear it again, or
No. Because I'm going to say no, and I think I know where Mikey got the inspiration for the question.
Do you want to call the shot all the way?
Because I didn't realize the answer is no. You are correct. So you gained a point on him that time. I didn't think about it until right now, but I think it was when they shot that Zach Galifianakis version of his video.
Zach Galifianakis Bon Iver video where they're on a tractor, and the first line is, I had a dream that I could buy my way to heaven. When I woke up, I spent it on a necklace.
I thought I pulled this out of my ass, but clearly I did not.
You had cryptonesia. That was there was that one.
The Bernstein effect or the Mandela effect.
Yeah. Or the bit we did literally 2 hours of making up movies on last week.
All right.
So we're 9-6.
We are to number 12. This one goes to Jlurp. Number 12. Hillary Clinton did the mannequin challenge standing next to Bon Jovi in the first class section of an airplane a week and a half before the election.
Say that one more time.
If Brian says say it one time. Okay. Hillary Clinton did the mannequin challenge standing next to Bon Jovi in the first class section of an airplane a week before the election. A week and a half before the election. Sorry.
She definitely did the mannequin challenge. The question is whether or not Bon Jovi was there. And you said you weren't, this wasn't going to be a matter of like 12 hours that something was going to be off, right? Like in these time things.
No.
Okay.
We're about to have a B-raid. Sorry, I was looking at the chat. That's really not my thing. Apparently 4chan? So, I don't know.
Nah.
So the question is, I am going to say yes, Bon Jovi was there. So yes,
so
this you happened.
Think it's real?
In 2016, a week and a half before the election.
I will confess that I was an instant no upon hearing it, but the confidence with which you said, yes, she definitely did the challenge.
It's a good read, Jerry. You gave him the information. You can't be mad you gave it to him.
It was so obvious to you that the devil was in the details that... It forces me in a position where it's like, well, I was definitely wrong with my first instinct.
How wrong has your first instinct been?
There is that.
I mean, the instinct itself has been wrong, but in a binary, it's right half the time.
Yeah, but now I can't figure out, like, now I'm asking myself, well, why wouldn't Bon Jovi be there? like if she's like the hard part for me to swallow was that she did the mannequin challenge. And if I'm picturing her doing the mannequin challenge, I can't picture her doing it anywhere but in first class next to Bon Jovi. So I'm going to have to say I think it did happen.
It did happen. So you both said it happened, yeah?
Yeah.
You're both yes?
Yes.
Sorry. It's hard when there's like 6 minutes from when the last person answered and I can't
it's
remember.
It's fine.
It is 10-6 per my calculations.
God, you're a national treasure. I hope Nicolas Cage doesn't steal you. but at least we now know he'd return you.
But if he does,
that's true. As long as
it was
as
for
long
the
as
right reason.
Right. The museum wanted me back. Number 13.
They're about to hand Mikey back, and then we just hear, he belongs in a museum, and it's Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
And they fight.
Dog's name was Indiana. Number 13 goes to Brian. Kylie Jenner launched a suite of name brand lines at Target, including clothes, accessories, board games, and even cooking supplies.
Yes, that happened. No, it was not in 2016.
So no.
Correct.
You gotta, yeah, okay, no. He answers no.
I answer no.
J-Man.
I don't really have much of a choice because I don't suspect that we have many more questions here. So I have to...
Two more after this one.
Yeah, I have to... Yeah, so I already lost, but I'm gonna say yes. Yes, it did happen in 2016.
Yet again, Brian is right for the wrong reasons. Never happened. Never, ever happened. Ever. Didn't happen in 2015 or 14. Just never happened. Board games? You think Kylie Jenner sells board games? Actually, neither one of you thought that. That's funny. Never mind.
No, the funny thing is that Target is handing out like big money for exclusive.
Yeah, they know they are. That's why I picked them. That's it. Yeah. Exclusively why I picked them. No, oh, I knew that would be hard. That one was hard.
There's a Shark Tank card game. I imagine someone would find a way to make a Kylie Jenner board game.
Number 14 is going to Jalurp first.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, Jalurp, I mean, the funny thing is I feel more confident about this quiz than any quiz you've ever done, and yet I'm doing terribly at it. Like, I feel like I've got
you're
more.
You're 6 out of 13, so not super strong.
No. This is a very bad performance, but I feel like I'm executing well on a bad performance.
That's okay. You're saving face. You know, it's good.
Yeah.
Number 14. Donald Trump accidentally spit into a reporter's mouth.
Sorry. Who's first, Justin or me?
Justin on 14, evens or him.
Okay.
Oh, I will not talk. Christ on a cracker. You gotta figure. Is there room to say intentionally or not?
Because that was my question. Like,
no,
there's
this
no
was
way
not intentional.
That didn't.
Not intentional.
There's no way that didn't happen. The question is, was it just ever reported?
I mean, somebody will say that, or there's going to be video of him just yakking it up. Yes, this happened.
Justin, may I request a rereading of the question?
Sure.
Donald Trump accidentally spit into a reporter's mouth.
Yeah, I'm going to say no.
It did not happen. Yeah.
That's the sound of civility. That's the sound of significant nods and courteous affirmations that we wish to, that our friendship is more important than the game itself.
It is currently 12-6.
Mm-hmm.
Please forgive me if I have trouble getting through number 15 in one go.
You got it. We believe in you. We believe you got this.
All right, going to Brian. Number 15. A Florida man protested in front of a Planned Parenthood dressed as Steven Seagal's character from Under Siege by attempting to launch fireworks out of his butt crack.
100% yes. Although you may be tricksy and be like, haha, it's Bruce Willis, but I don't care. I want to believe.
I want to believe in Florida.
Florida, man. And that, man,
what
magical words.
Number one, I can't even really feel all that bad because Brian missed one, and it was literally a strategic pick because I had already said the wrong answer. So I'm just going to go with Brian. Like, the right move was to follow the baby as it had its big day out. So, yes, whatever Brian says.
Come on, Florida.
It is not real.
No!
Brian missed three.
There's no way. There's no shred of reality to it.
No, that was 100% manufactured. I mean, dumb Florida people protest Planned Parenthoods, I'm sure.
Yeah.
And fireworks are sometimes involved, I guess. But I just made it up.
This is the most wonderful game we've ever had on this show.
Yeah, it's great.
That was a marathon. It took us a while to get there.
Worth it. Worth it. The cameo by Florida Man at the ending was delightful.
Everybody's calling me fake news in the chat right now.
So some people were saying a couple of those were 2015s or the like on the edge of the year. I don't know. That's very
good. Look, you guys don't understand.
I did my research and it was longer than the research you guys are doing by Googling.
Well, and plus also, let's declare
four of them happened in January of this year. For the record.
Yeah. Oh no, anybody who thinks that Mikey is
or last year. Sorry, not last year. 2016. It was all in 2016.
But for the record, like per the rules of the game, it does not matter factually whatever happens anywhere. To the extent that the game is Do we believe Mikey has done sufficient research that he believes that this thing happened in 2016? And that's the end.
There's also no prizes and no, there's no anything. It's just we're entertaining you and stop complaining.
Yeah, speaking of entertaining people, let's take a moment and talk about how are things going over at Movies with Mikey. What's your latest?
I did one at the end of last year. It went up on December 31st for the Grand Budapest Hotel.
Yeah, that was Grand Budapest. That was fantastic. I mean, all of them deserve for everybody to watch it, but there was so much there in that last Grand Budapest one that I was just like, as soon as you got into the whole framing thing, it just totally blew my mind. It melted my face.
It's very dense. That's why I built into part of the, because now I'm just screwing with the form of it now because I'm bored, but like I wanted it to be the cyclical thing that you watch it more than once and it takes on different meanings just like the film, but now it's commentary about it by doing it. It's weird. Meta.
You know, we actually had a lot of fun. We were doing the giveaway videos and we noticed an unintended side effect of we embedded codes that had to be deciphered to enter a second secret drawing through things. So you watched it once to enjoy, you know, whatever horse crap I do and participate in the giveaway, but you had to look with extreme detail going back. And I think the YouTube gods liked it because those performed pretty well for a while. And then it became clear that there are exactly 3,000 people playing that game and no more. And so we've kind of wound that down. But you may try throwing it in, like, do what you do. Do what you're doing. That thing. That thing literally you described what you're doing, you should do it.
By the way,
I totally lost track of that one.
Baka down in the chat says we need them weekly, Mikey, for which, you know, you do them weekly. Like, those are like they take time, man. Like, those are like, you can't do those any quicker than you do them without a staff.
Well, yeah, or going full time on it or something, because I still have a full time job during the day.
Yeah.
And by the way, you know, we've chit-chatted about the creative level of work it takes to put into your job. I don't understand how you have anything creatively in the tank when you come home and in the evenings. That's you have to pour an awful lot into each of these.
Yeah, it's because it's what makes me happy. I mean, you guys were talking about it earlier, but I'm doing Movies with Mikey live at PAX South.
So is this going to be like a live TED Talk kind of breakdown thing or?
No. So it's well, yes and no. I don't know. So the joke was that I was going to do a Movies with Mikey about Movies with Mikey live. So I was going to deconstruct my own show and it's going to be haha ironic and sort of poke fun at myself.
Yeah.
And in going through the process of putting this presentation together, I had an and this happened like 2 hours ago. I had an actual breakthrough about what my show was and what it means to me and what it is. So it actually sort of became like a real, which is what happens with the show, is I'm like, I'm not going to do the serious ending this time. And then it swings that way anyway, just because like that's sort of natural part of the process. But yeah, I dissected the show and actually found something profound underneath it that I'm going to share. Which is kind of trippy.
So somebody in the chat just said, wait, whoa, Movies with Mikey isn't his full-time gig? Huh? And it's like, MFers, I don't think you realize who you have in the room. Can we drop a mic and let these people know what's going on?
I mean, listen, obviously, he does Movies with Mikey in his part-time. His full-time job is creating quizzes for this show.
He also has another gig. Think of your favorite moment in any Gearbox game ever. I'm going to overstate your role. Think of your favorite line from anything ever you've ever done on any Gearbox game ever. Mikey wrote that thing. That's my claim.
Maybe. I wrote less on Borderlands 2, but other than that, yeah.
Other than less on Borderlands 2, everything else.
Well, yeah, if you're gambling on whether or not.
Much for sequel.
Yeah, no, dude writes.
I do a lot.
There's a reason we don't let Nicolas Cage on this podcast, and that's because he'll steal him. He'll steal him away.
I don't want to work with Nicolas Cage. This seems like a really bad idea.
We are going to be at PAX South on Thursday doing a meetup Thursday night. Are you gonna be around then?
I'm in Thursday during the day. I mean, where are you guys doing it?
Are you doing it down by
the hotels or anything? There's a lot of hotels and bars and stuff around there you could sort of clue people into.
So right now it's 7 p.m. at the Leapin' Lizard Pub down in that Riverwalk area on Thursday night.
I think they're open later than most other places down there, if I remember correctly.
I have never
been to the same place.
Yeah, I have never been to PAX South, so... So this will be...
How big is it in terms of like a swell of people? You know, I know what Dragon Con looks like with, you know, 50, 60,000 people there. How many folks, like, how much of a bloated blowfish does San Antonio turn into?
If I was going to guess between, like, this year, probably between 25 and 40, but don't have anything to back that up other than previous years. So it's slightly smaller than East. But we've sort of like the people that have been going to South all these years, we kind of made our own group. So it's got its own feel and it's, I don't know. I love it. San Antonio is a great place to do a convention.
It is lovely.
It's right on the River Center.
Well, and plus also like so much of San Antonio is designed, you know, for that touristy kind of stuff, which, you know, as a local, you kind of want to roll your eyes and say, touristy San Antonio. But then you go there and you're like, wow, everything's really pleasantly laid out. And I like how everything's themed. And it's easy to get from point A to point B and stuff.
And if you care, you can walk to the Alamo from the convention if you've never seen it.
Yeah.
You can remember it after you see it.
God damn it.
There we go. Baby's day out. Look at Brian. To memorialize the win with the Harambe with the flying V.
This is great.
There's a lot going on. There's a lot to unpack here, guys.
Scotty Mo.
Undeniably, irresistibly, irrationally funny. Baby's day out.
That's amazing. Hey, Mikey, how many people are you hoping come? Do you know what kind of room you're working? Do you have a set, like, I'm a failure at this number of people, I'm awesome at this number of people?
Also, no pressure.
I'm not expecting to fill the room. It's Falcon Theater, which I think is the second largest because one of the ones they do Twitch streaming out of. So it will be live streamed on Twitch.
But you're in the big room.
The big room is main theater.
See, that's the kind of thing like Justin and I, like, we, you know, Dragon Con, you know, we packed out
Crystal ballroom.
Yeah. I knew it had something to do with diamonds. But then they're all like, well, we clearly have to get you a bigger room. To which Justin and I were like, it was kind of fun just packing out that one place.
And also the room they put us in was garbage. And it doesn't really make sense to have more seats in a room where you can't see any better the further that you go back and you're just on a flat thing where you're looking at the back of people's heads. So,
yeah, it's worse at PAX East because the Gearbox panels are always main theater stage. But, like, in Seattle, the main theater is this awesome, like, opera house. You have to walk down the street to. It's amazing. But at PAX East, it's just a huge ballroom of, like, 2,800 to 3,000 seats. Like, it's crazy.
Oh, my God. Well,
we filled it three times, though, just saying.
I don't care if I have to pull a piece to get into PAX South. I am going to be there for Movies with Mikey on Saturday.
Sure, you'll need badges. Just hit me up. I'll try to hook you up with the right people to get that. Done.
Hey, how many? And this is going to be a weird one for me because I'm ashamed to admit that I just have never been dialed in. I live in Austin, so it's all South by Southwest to me is all I ever pay attention to, and this is close enough to it that I don't think about it. But who else from our Diamond Club family? How many orbits close to you and me, Justin, are going to be there? I think we have concerns.
Do you guys orbit like we have concerns?
Oh yeah.
Like with Jeff and Anthony Carboni and stuff.
BFFs, oh yeah, no, they're in the fam.
Yeah.
Is that back to back? Are they in the same theater or?
Loading Ready Run is in the same theater right before me.
We have concerns. Cactus Theater,
I think, is one of the satellite theaters.
What are there any other don't miss things? I know Giant Bomb has a big presence and
they haven't been there in a while.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Yeah, I haven't seen the wrestling stuff though we're not doing wrestling at South this year. So not that. We did Southern Slam last year. It was fun. I don't know. I like the Mexican food. Just
there's a lot of Mexican food.
There's a lot of good Mexican food down there.
I'm literally, if I can make We Have Concerns, I'm going to make it, and I want to see your panel, but other than that, I'm actually going to be there for WWE wrestling, because Royal Rumble is the same weekend, so
Wow, right on.
I have
a couple other panels, one with Mike Laidlaw and one with Susan Arnett. They're both sort of about overlooked games. You should look those up as well.
How's
those are the panels I'm doing.
Dude, well, all right. I guess we got to move on, but because all I want to do is gossip and ask how things are going with the YouTube channel, because the insider crap is like, I guess YouTube had an audit. I'm using air quotes and started giving away free views. I don't know what that means either.
I'm not seeing them if they are.
Well, I mean, that was my question. Because
I was going to say, I know where this conversation is going, and I don't think it's going to be.
Yeah, okay, whatever. Bonnie from the corner just wall tweeting goes, boring. Go back to Harambe, jerks.
Well, I'll tell you what. How about is something that I don't fail as spectacularly hard as I do with the quizzes. We take a look at the Movie Draft Minute.
Welcome to Movie Draft Minute, presented by CosmicRadio.tv for the week of January 16th, 2017. I'm your host, Roberto Villegas. Happy birthday, Schwood and Amtrekker, and to everyone who happens to have a birthday this week. So, with all that said and done, let's go check the scoreboard. Mikey Newman's in sixth place, $133.1 million. Chris Gates is in fifth place with $288.5 million. Milongo AE is in fourth place with $378.8 million. Justin Young's in third place with $382.9 million. Brian Brush is in second place with $395.3 million. And in first place, whopping $653.8 million. It's Team DTNS, and that is your Movie Draft Minute for the week of January 16th, 2017.
Yeah, man, gift that keeps on giving, that sing, all them kids, seeing people sing.
And so what, so you guys selected the founder everything out, triple wrong. X.
Where do you think you went awry, Mike?
Oh, wait, no, I still have Lego Batman, though. My actual big buy hasn't hit yet. All the rest was bullshit anyway.
Yeah.
Also, Rings hasn't hit yet either, has it?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think Live by Night has either.
I mean, I was depending on Assassin's Creed not to just crash into the sun.
Oh, did it? Did it already release?
It got really bad reviews.
Oh,
yeah,
Lego
Batman's
so sad.
My big grab, so I'm gonna move up a few places, right? Like,
man, Assassin's Creed. I saw that trailer and I was like, I believe in video game movies. It looks like they'll actually try to tell the story of the video. Nope.
From a trailer? A trailer made you think a movie might be good?
Yeah.
A bad movie might
be good? Yeah, yeah, yeah. But I'm a sucker for all that.
Yeah.
That Mikey wince is pretty much the most critical that I think I've heard you be about a movie ever, considering how nice you are about movies with Mikey when pointing stuff out about the Assassin's Creed trailer.
Well, I point out bad. I mean, it was a bad film. What is there to? It's an incoherent mess that doesn't respect the material nor its fans, and it didn't do good. Like,
well, I guess, and
that's
and,
the expected result. I just thought maybe it was good. When I heard it was bad, I was like, well, shit.
Yep. Yep. Man, long season this go around. You want to take a moment and do a little Diamond Time?
Well, of course, Brian, Diamond Time is where you can shout out your projects right here on the show. Just head on over to our subreddit, diamondclub.reddit.com or reddit.com/r/diamondclub. There's a big old sticky post at the top where you can shout stuff out, including Matthew DPX, who writes, Diamond Group, I'm the father of two premature children. My 4-year-old son was born 10 weeks early, and my 9-month-old daughter was born 6 weeks early. They both are doing very well considering how early they were born, but are both developmentally delayed and receive a variety of different types of therapy each week. Jesus.
Sorry about that. That's coming up.
That was not unintentionally tacky, dramatic music being dropped in.
Oh, my God. Holy crap. No, I'm not asking for money for myself or my children. Rather, I'm asking you, the unstoppable force that is the Diamond Club, to help the fight against premature births. My wife and I are walking in our local March for Babies event to help raise money for the March of Dimes, which performs medical research to prevent premature birth and offers a variety of services to families with premature children. I know that there are a lot of national charities that burn a lot of money on administrative costs and don't do a lot to accomplish their missions, but the March of Dimes isn't one of them. They're funded. They funded the research for a drug called Surfactant that helps the lungs of premature babies mature. My son received this medication immediately after he was born, and he probably would have been stuck on a respirator for months without it.
Wow.
If you would believe preventing premature births is important, please set aside a few of your hard-earned dollars and contribute to our campaign to raise money for medical research to prevent premature births. You can make your donation at YOLO420.com.
Yeah, I was going to ask about that. Swag.
Yeah, that's YOLO420.com/babyswag.
You're doing so good.
It's no,
tell that.
It's the URL shortener of choice right here on
I just feel like maybe tonally next time we could use a different one. Because it does call into question the authenticity of the unintentionally.
Just, you know,
I'm not
reading
telling
that,
you.
And all, like, just reflexively, I'm thinking, is the March of Babies a thing, or did Mikey make it up?
Well, plus, God, also, no. I like the fact that he acknowledged, I love the fact that we exist in a world where there's public forums like the internet that that can grade charities and audit and say, like, hey man, if you want our thumbs up, if you want us to say all this money is actually going to babies, not to a bunch of fake BS, then I'm glad they have a good grade.
Totally. So YOLO420.com/babyswag. Donate!
Meanwhile, Make Noise writes, I made a cover of the theme song from that show that Justin hates. Click! It's in YOLO420.com/WestSwag. Let's listen.
Oh, now it doesn't want to play. Cool.
Oh,
thanks, SoundCloud. I love you. You're here, a great
it goes,
service,
it goes
I'm
like
glad
this.
You're still around.
Bling, blong. Oh.
There we go. You can get it at YOLO420.
Sorry, what?
Yeah, there we go. You can get it at YOLO420.com/WestSwag.
That's a tricky theme because it's not sticky the way...
I think it's got a one moment where it's like...
That dun, 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 but it's like you got to wait a minute and you're like, oh yeah, that's that one part I remember.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Ion for Life writes, hello, Diamond Club. I have started a streaming show called Ion Games on my little production company, Clam Bake Productions. For now, mine is the only show, but I hope to grow just beyond me. With Schwood's goal setting in mind, I set the goal for 100 subs at the end of 2017, but what I really want to get is your feedback, as well as eyes on what I'm doing. Head on over to bit.ly/clambakeproductions to see the 3 weekly videos I'm posting at a minimum. Thanks in advance, and Diana Fire. The clickable link, bit.ly/clambakeproductions.
Man, the number of people who we saw as names in a chat room who are now content producers, some of them the mightiest among the Twitch literati now. I love it. We're a factory, Justin. We make people who make hits. We don't make hits, but we make people.
But
who...
other people do very, very well after seeing us and being touched by us.
We're
if you would
makers.
Like to shout out your project right here on the show and eventually outgrow us, go to reddit.com/r/diamondclub or diamondclub.reddit.com.
I feel like I can't even talk about how I felt about the game because it just...
I like how you just edit me in there and I'm just like casually mixing a rum and coke. By the way, you're back in the air. Oh, am I? Oh, okay. No problem.
Cool beans. No, Brian, talk about the game. Talk about how you felt about the game.
It was so much fun, and I'm dumb as rocks, and I always lose, and it's fun that I've gotten lucky twice, but then eventually There'll be a regression to the mean because Justin, like, legitimately smells bullshit better than me, and I'm a big dumb dummy.
Not with Mikey. Mikey's my kryptonite, man. Like normally, like there's some tells
Can I share the trick this week?
Yeah.
What was that?
So instead of making it as, because the thing was, you guys both did really good. It's sort of a toss up at the end of the day without knowing the actual information. But I knew if I told you that it was all about the details and I overloaded the details, that it would screw with you. I didn't have to change any, because none of the little details on the two ones changed.
The only one that was date dependent was the first one, right?
Yeah, I mean, they all just happened to take place in 2016.
Well, and also, it's all fair game. Like, we understand. The moment your face shows up on the screen, like, you know, the game's on. You know, I mean, it's like, let's do this.
Brian, I think you should celebrate. This is something that I feel like we have
Brian,
gone.
Brian's ability to be right. So wrong is sort of amazing.
You know what it is? I don't want to act like I have any special talent except for the ability to gleefully let you know that I wasn't really aiming at that pocket. Like, I don't care if I'm right for the wrong reasons.
Yeah, you call 8-ball in the corner pocket and it somehow goes off the window in that dude's head.
Exactly.
And then it goes in another pocket and you're like, well, it went in. I said it would go in.
I played for the Washington Generals, and before I threw my shot, I'm like, I'm going to bounce it off this lady's head. And then I just throw it backwards, and it eventually gets there, but just for all the wrong reasons.
I mean, now we can reveal this was, Mikey and I got together, this was our birthday present.
You motherfucker. I swear to God. You pull, if you open a sealed envelope,
you
pull out a sealed envelope with the exact score and a picture of you two holding a newspaper.
That's the Benedict Cumberbatch I knew 3 weeks ago.
Exactly.
You're
right.
Like, no, you didn't. Come on.
Hey, do you hate Sherlock? Because Justin hates Sherlock.
I hate Sherlock. I love it.
I love it too.
I'm processing this season.
I haven't gotten the third one. I only watched the second one.
The second episode was great. The first episode had a lot of problems for me. The second one I loved, and I was like, they made it work. And the third one is just like,
I did not like the last season, and I did not like the first episode of this season. But that's all I've seen.
I watched the first two twice, and what's really interesting, because both Tom and I have reached out to Justin independently to ask again after Justin appeared on our show last night, because everything he said he hated or loved about Sherlock was dialed up to 11 in the second, like, both the stuff that he says, I absolutely hate this about Sherlock. I'm like, well, that's the loudest they did it in the second episode. And he's like, but I love this about Sherlock. I'm like, well, I think that's the loudest they did that.
We'll see. We'll see. I don't know. I really, it's a show that I want to like. How can you not root for the show, right? Because it's got all these great actors. You don't get to see people that are as talented as that kind of play roles that you really like and are easy to root for. I mean, obviously, it's a character that stood the test of time, and Benedict Cumberbatch is great at it. It's hard not to root for it, but it's also hard to also root for, like, oh, no, the villain remembered things, so it's a mutant power now, where it's like, oh, no, dun-dun-dun.
In his mind palace.
He remembers things, but not like normal people, man, no, really well. He's really great. He's never forgotten anything. It's nuts.
Except that time when one or more parties implanted fake memories in his head to shield him from the truth. Yeah. He'll break through the doors of his mind palace.
I also was not a gigantic fan of Sherlock just murdering somebody. Like, I feel like that's one of the hard and fast rules of a Sherlock, you know, in the universe they'd set up.
Announcing why he's allowed to do that.
It made the world better, a measurably better place.
I did not have a problem with that moment. I thought, and yes, you know, as clumsy as it felt, he's like, oh, but you forgot one thing. The writer's room was told I'm allowed to do this. You know? It's a good show. Good show.
To answer the question, comic, does Sherlock really care about making the world a better place? Yes, because season 3 was all about Mary Watson, and he shoots him to protect his best friend's new wife. That's why he does it.
I also was not a huge fan of her.
I loved her.
I watched it through the second time, like season 3 grabbed me the second time through because I knew that the through line was Mary, not John or Sherlock.
Yeah.
Because, like, their reuniting after 3 years was so awkward and weird. And then, strangely, immediately homophobic again because Moffat loves doing that. Like, the beginning of season 3 was tough. And then I think it really hit a stride. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what. Let's save this all for the after show because, there's things I want to say and there are people who don't want to hear them. A good show, gentlemen. Mikey, yes. where can we get more of your lovely, lovely face?
Well, definitely the best thing to do is go to moviesandmikey.com, check out my show, pick an episode of a movie you like. It's all interactive, and by that I mean it rotates when you mouse over it. That's why I wanted a website that didn't do anything else. Like, my contact button is one of those buttons if you want to email me, so it's just like I wanted everything just to be very simple. And then you can see me at PAX South next week. The Big Movies and Mikey Show is Saturday the 28th, 6:30 to 7:30 in the Falcon Theater, or check me out streaming live on Twitch, on the official PAX Twitches, and I need to start thinking of another quiz.
Dude, yes.
You do? I'll tell you what, I was hoping that maybe, because I was hoping that we'd be able to do a live show in San Antonio, but I don't know. Who knows if we can bring that together at such late notice, especially when the only way that this bar communicates with anybody from the outside world is via Facebook Messenger. Fun fact.
Brian, what do you got going on? Being much of a venue. I think you're going to... What?
I guess the thing is we don't really need a lot of room. I mean, we can literally stand in the back of a bar and just kind of like do the show and have people
hold
gather.
Mics. Yeah. I mean, as long as we could be heard.
The bigger thing is just finding a place that is walkable, you know, because we can find a place in San Antonio that where we could probably do it, but it's just a matter of
I think there's a couple of hotels. I need to get you the name of the one I'm thinking of, but there's one that has a huge, because it's attached to a bar, so there's a bar in there serving a lot of people, and then there's this huge lobby, and I think it's more conducive to recording a show, and you have a lot more room for people to show up, and it has a bar, mm-hmm. and it has a Starbucks.
If you can, all right, we'll talk. We'll talk.
Yeah.
It'll be a fun time. All right, Brian, anything else you got going on?
New product. In fact, I've thrown away all the products on scamstuff.com, and I've replaced them with a thing I like to call promises. You can buy a promise for $20 or buy a promise for $50. What will you get for the promise? A promise that I will try really hard to please you.
What?
That's literally what we're doing. We're doing mystery boxes.
It looks like you're trying to be Overwatch, dog. No,
I mean,
maybe someone was thinking about that when they made these graphics.
And maybe you're talking to them right now. No, we're doing... So over the year, we get a lot of weird stuff kind of accumulates as we ship out stuff from Scam Stuff at the warehouse. Some of the, you know, like I sign a book and I fuck up their name and I feel bad about it. And I was like, well, I can't do that. Or a book gets crunched in the corner. Or maybe we open a deck of cards to use it for sample and then we receive, you know, put it back together. This year, though, we had an interest. And normally what we do is we collect this Island of Misfit Toys. And then we just throw them out as bonuses, free bonuses, like, hey, this week only spend more than $50 and we'll throw you a free thing. But this time we had enough stuff that we were uncomfortably over-leveraged on, where I was just like, okay. Yeah, like this year for holiday season, we were like in a battle stance where it's like, not going to give me this year. I'm going to be ready for all of y'all to buy everything. And then the dust settles and I was like, okay, good news. We got everyone, everything they wanted. Bad news, we have a little bit more of this stuff than I was hoping we would have. So we're doing mystery boxes, and my, you'll notice that the shipping is feels expensive on them. That's because we set the shipping at whatever the heaviest option would be. So either you'll open it and be all like, oh, well, no wonder shipping was so expensive. Or you'll open it and be all like, well, there's no way it costs this much to ship, but I am not going to complain given what I'm looking at right now.
So, oh, that's an interesting solution.
Yeah. So, like, my goal is to make you happy.
You pay too much for shipping and you get a better thing.
Exactly, right? And yeah. So
with the things that are in these boxes, it is crazy that they are this price even with shipping.
Yes. My goal is not to make money on this. My goal is to be less scared that in 3 years I'm a dumbass with lots of objects in a warehouse that aren't moving.
Okay, now Brian's going to talk about it. Here's the deal. Brian's got a lot of stuff. It's too expensive. He can't sell it for this amount of money when it just has the name on it. But if you do the little hole in the sheet where it's like, oh, no, wait, but if you don't know what you're getting, then this really expensive thing that I don't want to sell for all that cheap but I have a lot of can come to you for a greatly reduced rate for only the very little risk of just Brian will promise you that it won't blow. Don't worry. It'll be expensive.
Oh, yeah. No. Full satisfaction guaranteed, man. Like if you're like, you know what? The only game I'm not going to play is you don't get to go gambling hoping to get, you know, the three cherries, and instead you get three lemons, and it pays out, and you're like, well, I mean, I was really hoping to get three cherries, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, that's the only thing I don't want to hear.
Eat poop. If you don't like it, eat poop. Know that it's very expensive poop.
Yeah, yes, exactly.
Ben 10 says, didn't this show get a lot of mileage on episodes about broken promises? Those were like years ago. everybody, Justin R. Young is where you can find me. Stickers or DIAF is where you can get the sticker packs. And I am working on a new card game that will be the spiritual successor for the Contender. Hopefully more information on how people can play test that going forward. But the best way that
by the way, for the record, I'm gonna talk out of school just a little bit. I experienced part of it under a previous theme, and then I heard what the new theme is, and my interest was at like, this seems like tactically interesting to, holy shit, this is amazing.
I don't want to be publicly kind of projecting, but I think it's a more accessible game than the Contender for sure, because politics scares a lot of people off. But this, I think, is going to be not only a better game, but also, I think, a more accessible game. So we're going to launch that Kickstarter a little bit later in the year, but we do need playtesters. So if you want to be a part of that, go ahead and find the Contender mailing list. You can get that at thecontender.us.
Dude, great episode. Thank you so much, Mikey Neumann. You are a champion. Yep. Never let Nicolas Cage near you. We learned.
Steal me.
We learned that there are lines that should not be crossed. I got a warning. I got a yellow card this episode, Justin.
You did.
But I got to finish the game. Okay. What about you, bud?
See you next Tuesday.
Hey, man. Stay alive forever.
Ryan Brushwood, every time you leave, I wanna hurt myself by pissing off some bees. I'm allergic to bees. Oh, Justin Robert Young, every time you go, I get so sad that I wanna drink a warm glass of Drano. Night attack, night attack, night attack. 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 I love you.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.